Push movie review. Nick is a young man who has the ability of telekinesis. One day he meets Cassie, who can see the future, and together they have to try to rescue the young woman named Kira, who has recently escaped from the Division Research Labs, where people like them, people with superpowers, were being experimented on. This is essentially a gritty and realistic movie about people with superpowers. It takes a pretty good approach. Much like Heroes, it focuses on the characters first and foremost. It doesn't have far too many characters like the X-Men movies, and you get a sense of the superpowers before you see a lot of the use. The acting is pretty good. The characters are likable and memorable enough. The plot isn't bad, although it does get a bit convoluted near the end. The effects are pretty good, though you can sort of tell that they were working on a budget. Now, the one thing that one always wonders with movies like this, and one should wonder, is of course the use of the superpowers. And they do a great job. They have some very creative uses. For example, the telekinetic people have a bit of a shootout. And, well, let's just say the guns don't have to be in their hands for them to use them because of the telekinesis. There's a lot of fun had with the whole Oracle power because there are several people in the movie who can see the future. And in general, it's just good, creative uses of power, and you're never lost as to who has what power. You get a basic idea of the limitations of the powers, and they have some great matches of, you know, a big draw for a movie like this is, of course, getting to see people with superpowers fight each other, and we have some pretty cool battles. All in all, it's not the greatest movie ever made, not even the greatest movie ever made about people with superpowers, but it's fun, it's got a good pace, and you can watch it at least once and just have fun with it. It might help if you don't overthink things too much.